Hi, I'm Don Simpson with AWS.
And I'm Patrick Hanna with CloudHesive. This is my architecture.
So Patrick, why don't you tell us about the architecture you have here?
Great. So at CloudHesive, we have a platform that we call ConnectPath. Mm-hmm. And what it does is it augments the capabilities available in Amazon Connect. One of the things we're going to talk about today in terms of those capabilities are its omnichannel capabilities as it relates to email.
Great. Well, so I see a couple of personas. We have a customer and an agent. Why don't we start with a customer and work through the workflow?
Great. So like many customers, they're typically going to engage with a company around customer service or technical support needs.
Okay.
So in this case, this customer has emailed the company they're doing business with for assistance in an order.
Okay.
So that email goes to our customer's email server and then forwards on to Amazon email service, in which an email receiving role stores the content of the email in S3. Mm-hmm. Also creates a record through a Lambda function invocation in DynamoDB.
Okay. And then also, so we have Amazon Connect here, and the information that's being stored here. So this is the original email, the content, the subject, et cetera?
Everything, including all of the attachments.
What happens with Amazon Connect in this flow?
Great. So our users are logged into Amazon Connect, and much like a typical Amazon Connect experience, those users have signaled that they're available to receive work. So what we do with that Lambda invocation is we create a task in Amazon Connect that routes that work item, in this case an email, to the agent using the same contact flow, routing profile, and queue roles that you might use for voice. That agent's now seeing that email on his or her screen, as well as the metadata associated with that original email.
Is there additional information that's being stored in Dynamo?
Yeah, so as you can imagine, typical email correspondence is gonna have multiple back and forth type responses, a turn. We use Dynamo to maintain the state of all of those turns, as well as how they relate to the tasks we've created in Amazon Connect. As an example, this agent may be off shift. The customer may send another email in. We're going to use that lookup in DynamoDB to create a new task in Amazon Connect and route to a different agent.
So we have Translate and Bedrock. How do they fit into this flow?
Yeah, so given our early success in Omnichannel, we also saw an opportunity to help bridge the communications gap between that customer and the agent in cases where they may not necessarily be able to correspond in the same language. So what we do is when that email is loaded into the agent's interface, we'll give them the opportunity to translate that message from the customer's natural language into the agent's natural language.
Also, you get the benefit of today, maybe it's 75 natural languages and dialects supported. In the future, it'll be more. So managed services seem to be a key to your architecture.
That's what we love about some of the AWS managed services. As their capabilities are increased or enhanced, our platform's capabilities are increased or enhanced at the same time.
Excellent. So I'm really excited to hear about how you're using Bedrock.
So as a kind of an early model, we implemented Amazon Bedrock in the same manner that we implemented Amazon Translate. Mm-hmm. So the agent makes a request to Amazon Bedrock to provide a recommendation on how to respond based on the original email message. Bedrock then provides a series of potential responses back to the agent, which that agent can then click and will automatically insert into the reply back to the customer.
Right. So can you tell us a little bit about maybe some of your early experimentation? We have customers that are looking at fine-tuning, you know, prompt engineering. Is that something that you and your team have gone through?
Yeah. So sort of in the interest of kind of fast early experimentation, we understood, you know, based on the availability of certain foundational models in certain regions, we needed the ability to select what we thought were good functioning defaults as far as foundational models go, but also give the ability to override or even fine tune those models based on specific customer scenarios. So we've built all of that in as far as a configuration item goes in DynamoDB.
So you've also had this deployed in the customer's environment, so regulatory and compliance for compliance reasons, and as well as being able to train the models based on their customer interaction seems like it's key.
This is the customer deployed side of the solution, right? So we're able to deploy these services in the same exact region that the customers opted to operate Amazon Connect in to help with some of those regulatory needs.
So Patrick, what are the primary benefits of this architecture?
Yeah, so we see three benefits with it. The first is given it's all serverless mm-hmm. and runs in the customer's account, we're able to maintain both any of the customer's regional compliance needs or mm-hmm. data ownership needs, as well as maintain a very tight margin target for our own operating costs as well. The second thing we really like about this is as these services add capabilities and features over time, we're able to take advantage of that. Really, the third is, given its ease of initially setting up an experimentation, we're able to start to see results much faster. We spend more time in kind of the build and the execute than right. we do the upfront design work as well.
So Patrick, what's the benefit to the agent in using Bedrock?
In this example, you know, we're really giving the agent suggested responses and how to respond to the customer for a given prompt. That's going to decrease some of the toil on the agent, some of the cognitive load on the agent, and allow them to reduce both the back and forth, as well as respond faster to that customer.
Awesome. Well, thank you, Patrick, for sharing your architecture today.
Thank you, Don. Mm-hmm.